थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस ऑन अ ब्रांड न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ 420 ग्राम्स। 2:15 बजे हमने ये बैठक लगाई थी। इनफैक्ट हम 1:45 पे आ गए थे क्योंकि 2 बजे का हमने यहाँ पे आप लोगों के लिए हमने प्रमोट किया था कि हर संडे 2 बजे हम आपके सामने 420 ग्राम्स की बैठक लगाएंगे। एंड पिछले 3 संडे से ट्रूथ बी टोल्ड हम लोग आ रहे हैं और ये एक बड़ा अच्छा मैं अक्सर सिद्धांत को इतना मैं क्या कहते हैं आई डोंट गिव हिम टू मेनी कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स बट ट्रूथ बी टोल्ड ये आइडिया सिद्धांत का ही आया था। बिकॉज इससे पहले आइडिया जो चल रहे थे वो थोड़ा मेरा था कि न्यूज जब ब्रेक होती है तो फिर अगर आप डिजिटल माध्यम पे काम कर रहे हैं तो आपको वो 1-2 दिन का विंडो आता है जब सब लोग ऑफकोर्स ट्रैफिक बढ़ता है उस टॉपिक के बारे में बात करने के लिए और फिर हमें वहां पे हमारा वीडियो डालना चाहिए। लेकिन सिद्धांत ने कहा नहीं भाई, व्हाट्स मोर इम्पोर्टेंट इज दैट यू हैव अ टाइम टेबल एंड यू स्टिक टू दैट शेड्यूल एवरी वीक। सो आवर शेड्यूल गोइंग फॉरवर्ड For those of you who might not know, for those of you who know, we love you for all of that. Every Sunday at 2 p.m., 420 grams is coming your way. Aaj hua kya? 1:45 pe aaye sabse pehle Jaideep Basu, the most senior person on this panel, and of course the most respected person on this panel. Uske baad aaya 1:55 pe main with this lovely flowery shirt and without the shades. Kyunki shades mere ko baad mein idea aaya, to isliye maine shades pehen diya. Uske baad aaye hamare daadi wale bhai jo kafi gusse mein lag rahe hain ki main unke channel pe aake kafi bakwas kar raha hu. लेकिन भाई अब कुछ कर नहीं सकते, 4 साल से कर रहे हैं, अब क्या वो रोकोगे आप?
यू नो द थिंग इज पंडित, आई डोंट थिंक वी आर लाइव ऑन YouTube। डज एनीवन एनी वन ऑफ यू गाइस हैव YouTube ओपन?
नो, इट्स शोइंग लाइव ऑन YouTube भाई।
नो, आई नो इट्स शोइंग दैट ऑन Zoom, व्हिच इज द सॉफ्टवेयर दैट वी आर यूजिंग टू कनेक्ट।
ये अलग ही गेम हो जाएगा। नहीं, आ गया भाई, आ गया। इट्स लाइव ब्रो। ऑलराइट,
I don't know, for some reason, I've got YouTube open on my computer and it's not showing up. That's why I was...
There's this thing you can do, it's called refresh.
Thank you.
No,
thank
I,
you.
I think this is
a problem with this channel. Everyone thinks that they're super smart.
Hello, ma'am. No, bhai, see, the thing is, YouTube has broken up with you just like your knees have given up with you as well.
Shubh bol, bhai. Your knees, my knees are intact. Thank you very much.
Do I look like I'm injured? Just look at my look. Do I look like I'm injured? Anyway, so मैं बीच में क्या बोल रहा था कि and slowly संख्या बढ़ रही है, यहाँ पे लोग आ रहे हैं वापस। Guys, thanks for joining us. Sorry यार, चिन्मय सिंह भाई वाइसोलेट में बता रहा चिन्मय। तो आखिरी में हमें ज्वाइन किसने किया एट 1:59:45, वो थे वैभव जो कुछ मैन्युअल लेबर करके आए थे। आई थिंक घर के पास कुछ ईटे लगा रहे थे भाई, सीमेंट?
नहीं, मैंने एक्चुअली साइड जॉब ले रखा है स्विगी डिलीवरी का, तो मैं साइकिल से गया था, स्विगी से डिलीवरी करके आ रहा था।
तो व्हाट आर यू डिलीवरिंग, योर सेल्फ एस्टीम?
नो, या फ्रेंच फ्राइज विद सेल्फ एस्टीम।
क्लोज इनफ। नाउ देखो जी, मजाक की बातें हो गई हैं, दोस्त लोग हमारे आने लग गए यहाँ पे। पॉइंट इज कि आज हम लोग बैठक क्यों कर रहे हैं, एक तो बिकॉज हमारा शेड्यूल है। रेनेडी सिंह और इश्वाक अहमद हमारे साथ है नहीं, लेकिन हमारे जो पुराने पापी हमारे साथ यहाँ पे हैं, क्योंकि हमें ना सिस्टम पे हमें वार करना बड़ा पसंद है और आज सिस्टम पे ही वार होने वाली है। क्योंकि जयदीप बासु ने, अगर आपने नोटिस किया होगा, अ फ्यू डेज बैक, एंड दिस इज पर्टेनिंग to the two teams that have got bids accepted for the I League in the coming season and the season after, that being Sudeva FC and Srinidhi. Now, when that news, of course, came out, Jaideep wrote a very nice article talking about the one city, one team rule, which the AIFF has implemented, which, of course, then impacted Srinidhi, which is a Hyderabad-based team, who had to then have their bid accepted from Vishakhapatnam or वाइजैक। तो उसके बारे में आज बातचीत करेंगे, मेरिट्स एंड डीमेरिट्स ऑफ दैट रूल, क्योंकि मेरे हिसाब से काफी अंधेरा लग रहा है। ये शायद मुझे ऐसे लग रहे हैं क्योंकि मैंने चश्मे पहने हैं। अंधेरा, ये तो ऐसा नहीं है कि हम सिस्टम को इतना पसंद नहीं करते, हमें सिस्टम बहुत पसंद है। AIFF, आई लव यू गाइज। लेकिन आज आपकी यहाँ पे इतनी तारीफ नहीं होने वाली जनाब। तो सर, सबसे पहले, बिफोर ऑफ कोर्स वी गेट अहेड, लेट मी टेल यू, बिकॉज़ वन ऑफ द टीम्स आई गॉट अफेक्टेड कर्टसी ऑफ दिस वन सिटी वन team rule was an upcoming team in the second division, that is Bangalore United, and their head coach Richard Hood joined the boys a few days back. So first and foremost, I'm going to throw it to what Richard had to say, because he has put out the official word for Bangalore United, and then of course we can take the discussion forward.
Tell us what you were looking at. Of course, you've been on the show before talking about Bangalore United's plans and how you're kind of shaping up and creating a team for competitive for competitions. You were looking at the I-League second division, if I'm not wrong. So tell me what exactly happened and how things went in terms of your conversations with the All India Football Federation.
I mean, like you know, our last game, I think it came in just in the time when the pandemic broke out, as in when they had decided that there won't be any more matches. So even our last game was behind closed doors with all the protocols that were in place. And then after that, we kept waiting for about a couple of weeks to find out when we would resume. And then the actual lockdown was announced. So I think the I-League got its conclusion in terms of Mohun Bagan being champions and there being no relegation with Aizawl being saved. And there's a big question mark on the I-League second division. With no real restart date being scheduled and things, the tender when it was released sort of caught our attention. That's the management of the club, to figure out if we can sort of give a conclusion to the season by going in for this option now, because there really wasn't any clarity in terms of what would happen. So I think there was an aggressive push in terms of at least inquiring about the direct entry and seeing if that was a viable option to conclude our season.
Right. And how did that then transpire? Why did you sort of decide to back away from that process? Because we're of course focusing on what seems to be an unwritten one city, one club rule that seems to be in existence as far as the top management of the league structure in India is concerned. Ki agar aapke club mein already ek city hai, sorry, aapke city mein already ek club hai, jo jo ISL ya I League mein khel raha hai, then essentially other clubs are not being encouraged to look for a way into the same league system.
So I think for us, we didn't want to read in too much into the the tender document that said cities like, and then there were a whole bunch of cities that were listed. So we had inquired from the point of view, can we bring Bangalore into the league as well? So I think we didn't perceive it as a one city, one rule, but we were told that AFF was very specific about the cities that they would be accepting bids from. And we were asked to focus on the tournament that we're preparing on for now. That's a viable merit-based outcome to sort of find a conclusion again. So I think AFF was quite clear in those terms that we would rather that you all focus on the tournament that you all were already a part of.
Right. So not really clear that it's based on the fact that BFC are in the ISL and therefore there's, I don't know.
We didn't. Yeah, like I said, it was not much to read into. As in, they said these are the cities we. So I think sort of taking a hint from that, we had to respect the decision that AFF had conveyed. Probably Bangalore is not in the radar for this window of direct entry teams, and they would be looking at other cities.
And so now that this direct entry option is out of the question, how then do you go back to the drawing board, and what is Bangalore United planning for the upcoming season?
We've been quite discreet about all of these signings as well as preparation plans, because one is we need to sort of get a grip on where exactly do we stand, because just from the player well-being point of view, we are looking at 5 months out of football action. So no matter how much conditioning and things they have done away from the program, we started a few days ago, and right now it's just everything's indoors. We're trying to figure out their body compositions, get all these sports science tests done. Because the injury becomes a huge issue, and the tournament isn't a very it's something like you have your finals and stuff at the end of the season. Now the pura khel ke, then you have a final and semi-final. Yahan pe seedha knockout tournament of sorts, as in 4 matches to decide who gets promoted. So the high stake outcome is right at the start of the season, as in we are getting into the deep end straight up. So if you're looking at 4 games over a span of about 12 to 14 days, we have to sort of condition ourselves to do that. Maybe the 72-hour break between each game might be a silver lining, and also the 5 substitution rule. Yeah. Will also make help us. Like in visa, I mean, the success factor.
Fair enough. Vaibhav, Jaideep, any questions for Richard before he leaves us, and then we can continue our wider conversation around the subject?
No, I don't have really any question about it, because he has already specified what he had to say. So I cannot get in. I don't really want to get deeper into it because, frankly, I know what is happening and how it is happening and why it is happening. So it's enough for me what he has said so far.
Can I ask something of Richard, if you don't mind? Like, is this high stakes outcome you're saying, this knockout style tournament for promotion, like there's like at various levels this is happening also, like right now, for example, it's happening in the Champions League in Europe, right? It's a similar sort of situation. Like, is it like something beneficial to like, say, the sort of smaller teams maybe? Is that something you guys like think about?
I think yes, because it's also, I mean, Bangalore, as team like Bangalore is, United is really new, right? So we're just a couple of years old. We're competing against 100-year-old entities like Bhavanipur and Mohammedan Sporting. So one good thing, I mean, we just discussed before we were off air that quality of players coming into this tournament is really good, because you have a lot of guys who didn't get enough playing time in the regular I-League, in the regular ISL. And now it's a good chance for them to get a good solid pre-season. And this transfer window as well allows three clubs. As in, this year players can sign for three clubs across two transfer windows. So, I mean, that flexibility that we get, I think the stakes are high. So, players get a chance to prove that they are competent to be a part of a promotion bid. So, I mean, just in terms of the player, quality of players you're dealing with, the quality of opposition that we'll face, just the format, because this is a extraordinary season, right? I mean, this probably won't repeat itself with high-stake outcomes, high-quality players coming in to make up the squad. So, I think it'll show for itself. I think once the rosters are out, all five teams that are a part of it, you will see a much better quality compared to what we have seen in the January and February part of it.
And then it also gives the second division more visibility, right? Like, is that also like usually the second division doesn't get so much visibility. Like, that's.
I think players are very aware in terms of that people, there will be eyeballs on them. As in, that after this, they can move on. If the tournament gets concluded before the 20th of October, there will be clubs who will be interested in them. And plus, it's also a chance to get promoted. As in, for us, the whole idea is that we set a process that we can maybe carry on should we secure promotion. So, and that's what's helped us attract a lot of players as well into this whole project that we're trying to build now. So, I mean, fingers crossed.
So, I have one question to Richard. Can you just for the sake of curiosity, can you throw some light on your foreign recruits?
So, we've got Robert Primus from Churchill Brothers, centre back, who was part of the whole season last year. And we've got William Opoku from Bhavanipur, but he was part of the Minerva Punjab championship winning team as well. I think he featured prominently over there. So, I mean, it also gives us the chance to maybe any Indian strikers. We have knocked on almost every door that any of the young boys who are not getting to play in that part of the pitch in the higher leagues, maybe come down and give us 2 months of your lives and probably catch eyeballs again. So, whoever has signed up, I mean, we will build our teams around the Indian frontline and see what we can do to maybe highlight that and be successful with it.
Are you disappointed with the? Are you disappointed
with what, sir?
Are you encouraged or disappointed with the kind of Indian strikers you are watching at the moment?
No, we are quite and very very.
Excited.
For our season, we are excited because at least it's a simple calculation. I mean, we need to create enough chances for these guys to find the back of the net and strategize according to what we've got. So maybe the Indian strikers, one, they might not give us the sort of physicality that the foreigners might give us just by virtue of genetics and things. But if we can find a way to make them successful, then I think we'll narrow down on what works for us and find success with that.
So, Richard, I feel like if you guys play your cards right, there is like a striker in Bangalore, an Indian striker in Bangalore you guys could get. Like, he also plays for a big club in Bangalore, if I'm not mistaken. Like, do you guys like...
If he's willing to shift to that three-window thing, why not? Doors are still open, right? Doors are always open.
Richard, as a second division club, I have one question to ask you.
Yes.
That till last year... Till two seasons ago, players were allowed to go on loan at any part of the time, any part of the year, and then they changed the rule that only during the windows you can go on loan, which has created a lot of disappointment among a lot of teams and a lot of players in the second division and the lower division, because that is that's the way the players were moving from one team to another, even when the window was not there. So a lot of people feel that this rule shouldn't have been brought. So what do you say on this?
I think just from the point of view of maybe players' employment being hurt, because Bangalore League really benefited from the Calcutta League concluding and then those boys coming and playing three more months of Bangalore League and then I-League second division. So we're depriving them of maybe, let's say, last year Bangalore League was 11 matches plus maybe a whole season of the... So you're looking at 11 matches less for Indian players to sort of shuffle in and work between... and Calcutta League is quite competitive, so... without this rule, I think Indian players would have got somewhere between 30 matches then, between Calcutta League, Bangalore League and I-League second division. A minimum 30 matches if they were available for all of them. So maybe that 10 matches reduces their availability and also this earning opportunity, because then you're looking at about 3-4 months without wages. From the club point of view, yes, maybe even if there was some interesting talent in the B teams of the reserve teams who can come to us during the playoff stages of the I-League second division, maybe that would have been interesting as well, because we came up against really good quality Indian players with the reserve sides who would have helped us were they available. So I think that dynamic would have changed the playoff stages, at least that the best players continue across the few teams that survive.
Super. Good luck.
Lastly, just to conclude, Richard, how... In terms of course, this will all happen in a so-called bubble. So, how are you preparing for that scenario, and how are the players as well sort of gearing up for it or prepared for it, or and especially from a mental perspective, because we've seen now several leagues and several tournaments across sports happening in these bubbles. And there has been a lot of chat from athletes across the board talking about how in this bubble, you know, everything is very much single focused, and there's only cricket or only basketball or only football going on, and no sort of respite from that, no breaks.
Just how so do you how help them through cabin fever?
One is, I mean, in terms of maintaining the focus, yes, because one aspect is it's not a very long duration either. If the tournament starts in October, we would be on our way to Kalyani by mid-September. And the boys have been at home for the last 5 months, craving to play. I mean, that whole itch and things has sort of pent up now. So, from the look of things, I mean, the squad looks really driven and trying to prove a point. I mean, just the way they've greeted each other and things. So, the other aspect, what you mentioned is about the mental well-being, this being too much football or just seeing the same faces over and over again. I think everybody respects the fact that safety is paramount, especially with this pandemic going on. I mean, there can't be any slip-ups on that front. Tech-wise, I think everybody is enabled. Like, we're chatting right now. We're in a really, really isolated place, but we've managed to pull off the Zoom call and things. So, I think in the campus that we're in, the players will figure out whether signal works, doesn't, in case family, girlfriends, wives, kids, whatever it is, there is enough opportunity to sort of do that. And plus, as a coaching staff, we aren't really on them like CCTV the whole time. Right. I think we interact when we train and eat, and that's it. Remaining time, we really aren't mandating that they wear shoes all the time or club gear or stuff like that. If you're not training or eating together, the rest of the time, these guys are free to do what they feel like. So I think take the foot off the pedal on that front. I think it should be okay. It's 21 days, so...
काफी हमारे भाई लोग अभी भी हमारे बैठे हुए हैं यहाँ पे, सो थैंक यू फॉर दैट गाइस. एक हमारा भाई है यहाँ पे जो मुझे बोले जा रहे हैं, पंडित जी आप गाड़ी ले लो. भाई मैं यार हद होगी, आपको कैसे पता कि मेरे को गाड़ी की जरूरत है कि नहीं है, हैं? मे बी आई लाइक वॉकिंग ऑन फुट, मे बी आई लाइक टेकिंग उबर, मे बी आई डोंट गेट आउट ऑफ माई हाउस, यू डोंट नो. बट पॉइंट बीइंग, हाँ जी भाई,
बोल घड़ी बोल रहे हैं वैसे.
अच्छा ओ घड़ी. भाई घड़ी नहीं, फिर मेरे को चश्मों की जरूरत है, क्योंकि अपने को पढ़ना तो आता है नहीं. तो अपॉलोजीज फ्रॉम माय साइड. घड़ी ये ले लो भाई, चल रही है यहाँ पे. ये कैसियो है, मेरे भाई ने मेरे को कॉपी करके अपने पास भी ले ली. दिखा दे भाई अपनी कैसियो. ये रहा आपकी कैसियो. इट्स द बेस्ट. इट्स ऑन अमेज़न. यू विल गेट इट फॉर आई थिंक 700-800 bucks मैन. वाटर हेलस्टॉर्म एनीथिंग जस्ट पुट इट ऑन इट एंड सब ठीक हो जाएगा. सो जयदीप सर, जब आपने थोड़ी छानबीन करेगी, ऑफिशियल मेल तो आ गया सर, तो ऐसा नहीं है कि स्पेक्युलेटिव है या कुछ है. What is the thinking behind this rule? मुझे समझ में नहीं आया अभी तक.
See, I didn't know, frankly speaking, I didn't know about this official mail. But I know there was a verbal discussion was held, and they were told in no uncertain terms that if they have to play from play the Bangalore United for it, make a bid for a place in the ID, then they have to move to Mysore or to Mangalore or to any other place in Karnataka. So it is very clear they don't want another team from Bangalore. Nobody has specified why they don't want another team from Bangalore, but we know very well why they don't want another team from Bangalore. It has happened before also. This is not the first time it is happening. Last time, we know very well that U Mumbai, which is being run by Ronnie Screwvala, they wanted a team from Bombay in the I League.
They were very close.
They called for a trial also. And that time, All India Football Federation received a letter from their all-powerful marketing agents who told them that if you have to add another team in the I-League, as per that great agreement which was signed in 2010 or 2011, as per that agreement, you have to take the permission of the
commercial rights holders.
Commercial rights and the marketing agents of the Federation. And that was that. And U Mumbai was told not to go ahead with their program. They cancelled their trials, and that was the last time we heard from them trying to make a team for the I-League. So it is now very clear. Everybody can understand what is what. 2+2 always makes it 4. It never makes 5. We know about it. That they don't want a team to come from a city where there is already a franchise system.
Also, all the more that 24 mein aapka wo, it'll become one league. So
that is a different. But at the moment, there is a clear policy of protecting a certain a section of the franchises are being run. It is a clear policy we can understand. Even if they deny it, no problem. But we can stand up and say yes, it is like that. But the same policy, very frankly, this one city, one club policy, which is now making all the noise, it was not followed in 2014 when the new league was launched. Was it? No. There was a team from Goa. The team was launched in Goa. There were two teams, very formidable teams from Calcutta. A team was launched from Calcutta. Nobody objected at that point of time.
No, but that time there were different leagues, na, sir. That time there was, the window was not open. Ki promotion relegation hoga, and you will have a team which is going up to the ISL.
But
that
time
was a closed league.
But this time it is also a closed league. So far it is a closed league. Nothing else.
Is keeping an eye on 24, na?
Not keeping an eye on 24. I feel it is not keeping an eye on 24. It's keeping an eye that the support base of a particular team should not be divided. It's a very selfish policy. I make it very clear. It's a very selfish policy.
Narrow-minded.
It's a monopolization of. There is no democratic sense in it. Let me make it very, very clear. There is no sense of democracy in it. It's only to protect a few teams. And if this is the way the football is run, then God saves Indian football. Because All India Football Federation is no more running the show. We know who is running the show. Whether it is running from Dwarka or from Nariman Point, we all know from where it is being done.
Janab, aap aap aaye andar, aap kuch bola aapne?
इतने eloquently जयदीप सर बोल रहे हैं तो क्या जो मैं फालतू में मैं interrupt करूँगा खराब.
मैं actually क्या before I get you guys to jump in, see देखो जी दूसरा नजरिया भी होता है. अब मास्टर राइट्स अग्रीमेंट में पढ़ रहा था, मास्टर राइट्स अग्रीमेंट अपने पास आई भी है कर्टसी ऑफ मिस्टर बजाज, ठीक है, थैंक यू फॉर दैट मिस्टर बजाज. तो मैं बैठ के पूरा मास्टर राइट्स अग्रीमेंट पढ़ रहा था. नाउ आई एम नॉट वेरी वेल इक्विप्ड टू गो थ्रू लीगल जार्गन, बट जितना भी मैं उसमें पढ़ पा रहा था कर्टसी ऑफ माय लिमिटेड नॉलेज एज फार एज लीगल जार्गन इज कंसर्न्ड, इट सेड दैट व्हाटएवर द न्यू लीग इज फॉर्मड, इट वाज अ वेरी आर्बिट clause saying that whatever decisions taken to promote the new league must be adhered to by the federation and also the FSDL, whatever. So it was nowhere in the MRA is it written that there has to be one city and only one team, or we have to protect the interest. So that's what I'm saying, but it's arbitrary, because then any decision can be taken under the pretext of a clause that's in your master rights agreement, which is saying that we have to protect.
No, dude, like, so here, I will jump in, because essentially this master rights agreement, with the exception of certain clauses that protect essentially payments, right? Apart from that, the master rights agreement gives whatever entity is operating this league complete freedom to do whatever it chooses. So that's why the word undemocratic is spot on.
Why undemocratic? See, my point is, when your master rights agreement has been signed, it's not like उन्होंने पिस्तौल रखी है AIFF के यहाँ पे
खोपड़ी पे. नहीं, वो सब छोड़ो.
It's not like they've been. नहीं नहीं भाई. See, my point is कि आप कल को आप एक न्योता मेरे सामने लाते हैं. आपके पास एक business proposition है. No matter how skewed it may be, but आपके नजरिए से वो ठीक है, आपके लिए चल रहा है. The onus is on me to identify ये गलत है, ये गलत है, ये गलत है.
I agree.
And say get lost. Okay, but I have said yes.
हम तो जब हम भाई कितने सालों से कह रहे पूरा घर बेच दिया AIFF ने. This there's no.
हाँ तो मैं कह रहा हूँ FSDL के बारे में बात करने की ज़रूरत नहीं है इसमें.
नहीं बिल्कुल ज़रूरत नहीं है.
The blame solely lies with the AIFF. Solely and only lies with the AIFF. No one else.
जा रहा है. बंदूक तो रखा जा रहा है अर्जुन. Last year, PTI ran a story. It was run. The story was run by the biggest news agency in the country. And it was never denied. The PTI story said, I'm just saying what PTI story says. I'm not saying what I feel or I believe anything. Yeah. I can be accused of biased, which is often been accused of.
As long as you're reporting facts, right?
PTI story said that. The payment which every 3 months or 4 months the federation gets from its marketing agents, it was not released for two consecutive terms because they wanted their league to be given the number one status. As long as they were given to understand, as long as it won't be given, the money will not be released. The moment that status was given by the AFC, of course, not by AFF alone, the money was released. It was the story was released by PTI, and it is now 1 year. I have not seen a denial
sir,
of the story.
Sir, ghuma firake, I'm sorry. I agree. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा sir. मैं ये कह रहा हूँ कि ये ऐसी बात नहीं कि किराने की दुकान में साथ वाला आदमी आके कह रहा है कि चलो business करते हैं, partnership करते हैं. जनाब, आप federation चला रहे हैं. जनाब, आप you're one of the biggest corporate houses in the country, if not the world, right? My point is, if you are running federation, you have to do your due diligence.
One and, city, one club. There's a couple of comments coming in saying one state, that's wrong.
My point is, one city may, all you people who've joined us on YouTube, just let us know what you think of this rule. And have you seen any instance in the past where this one city, one rule has worked or has not worked? So then you would say that, you know, more clubs in one city sort of then drives the ecosystem to even flourish even more. Because Vaibhav, aapne sir jab padhai thodi kari hai, and countless examples all over the world where football is played and followed properly. What does that tell you when you have only one franchise or one city in one club in one city, or when you have multiple clubs vying for that one spot? How different are the two scenarios?
I mean, it's massively different. Like, let's not get into like the historical rivalries that have built up. They're called derbies, first of all, by the way. I just want to say. And just like I was saying the other day, of course, we have East Bengal, Mohun Bagan, Mohammedan, Sporting, Aryans, like all of them from the same city. So forget, like, we can drop that old historical rivalries that exist. There's Boca River, there's City United, all these exist. But let's just take it, the most modern rivalry, derby rivalry that has been manufactured, all right? And what it has done for that city's football. It's called the El Trafico, okay? It's Los Angeles Galaxy versus Los LFC. Angeles FC.
Yes.
All right.
Yes,
this is like very recent. This is 3 years, 4 years old. This is manufactured, boss.
So El Trafico could also be Bangalore United versus Bangalore FC.
Sir, apna ISL rivalries are all manufactured.
It could. I mean, if you
Southern Derby, traffic wale angle se.
Ab banao na, wo bhi banao na. Southern Derby banao. Koi mana nahi.
Look at what that has done for that city. Is like, I mean, when you, it's hilarious because the first ever El Trafico featured two players, one called Carlos Vela and the other one called Zlatan Ibrahimovic. For anyone who's watching this, you should just go and see that first derby, okay? That is where it kicked off. Like Zlatan ne ek bahut hi bhayankar 40-yard screamer mara tha as an equalizer. Carlos Vela ne hat-trick mara tha. And now that El Trafico is like a cultural event in that city. For a city that basically, it thrives on rivalry, sure. Basketball, Clippers versus Lakers. That's the big thing in that city. But football did not feature. Like, LA Galaxy's big thing was David Beckham. But now the big thing is, boss, we have to beat LAFC. And LAFC is similar. We have to beat...
And that drives the interest in the city.
Yes.
Absolutely. So, the growth of a game, and I would say, like, borrowing from El Trafico, if you have two teams from Delhi, you can have one of them like sporting like Kendriya Sarkar, the other one sporting Central Sarkar, and like we can have like a great game, yeah. You know, like maza aa sakta hai. And there are various stories like this. Like, I mean, you can just go on and on with manufactured rivalries, with old rivalries that have like also contributed to a city's culture itself. I mean, I don't know how much you want me to.
Manufactured in the sense, har cheez ka starting point to kuch hona padta hai na.
100%. But so, the point why I use the word manufacture is because we often...
It's created.
It's not created. Like AFC wasn't created because of a certain ethnic group or a certain racial group or a certain political affiliation that caused this club to come. It just grew out of like an old club that was taken over. More money was pumped into that club. And they were inducted into the MLS. But that's what I mean when I say manufactured. It's not a bad word. I don't want to use it like I'm not trying to be derogatory when I use it.
Shubham Nayak has taken your word very seriously. He's saying Modi versus Kejriwal Delhi Derby honi chahiye sometime or the other. Bhai, wo maza aa jayega wo match dekhne mein.
Hua to tha.
Aapka derby ya uska derby.
सर मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ कि हम चलो ठीक है भाई हमें बाहर की कहानियां बता रहे हैं व्हाई डू वी नीड टू इवन लुक आउटसाइड इफ वी लुक इनवर्ड्स
आई कैन
मोहन बगान बी एज बिग विदाउट ईस्ट बंगाल विद ईस्ट बंगाल बी एज बिग विदाउट मोहन बगान
अर्जुन
आई एम सॉरी टू लाइक जस्ट टेक वन आई जस्ट वांट टू मेक वन मोर स्मॉल पॉइंट वन ऑफ द पार्टनर्स ऑफ द ग्रुप दैट रन्स द टॉप लीग ऑफ दिस कंट्री नाउ दे आर अ ब्रॉडकास्ट पार्टनर एंड दे आर लाइक ब्रॉडकास्टर्स
Star
and
Sports bol do na bhai
ha Star Sports like I don't know but yeah I don't bhai. Know okay Star
it's a lovely
Sports.
Place to work yeah we love you Star Sports
so I just want to say whenever there is a like I watch a lot of as do I'm sure a lot of people who are watching this show we watch a lot of football and we watch a lot of European football I just want to say whenever there is United versus City or London mein Tottenham versus Arsenal ya Bayern versus or whatever Berlin Union versus Hertha They always make these great promos, which are one city, two clubs, the greatest rivalry ever.
I think they're very random type of. Anyway, sorry.
Yeah, but my point being, like you're using these words, there is like a blatant hypocrisy. I just want to point that out. Like that's all. I'm sorry, Jaydeep sir, to have taken this.
By business mein koi hypocrisy nahi hoti. Wo business deal hui hai aapki wahan pe ISL ko lekar because fir aapko TV rights nahi dene pad rahe. Simple si baat hai wahan pe. But Jaydeep sir, main to ye keh raha hu. Would Mohan Bagan be as big without East Bengal or would East Bengal be as big without Mohan Bagan?
See, Arjun, Mohan Bagan and East Bengal is the biggest example in this country. But there are so many examples. The Bangalore football came up. You look at the history of Bangalore. Bangalore football came up because of rivalry between Bangalore Muslims and Bangalore Blues. These were the two teams who met Bangalore football. What happened? How Delhi football in the 60s and 70s came up? You remember how much spectators used to attract? So Indian city club versus Indian national.
There
was one instance I still remember. I was a kid. I was in that match. Unfortunately, there was riots. They had to go for a curfew. And the stadium at that time was small. We jumped from the wall from the other side. There was so many people were throwing bottles and chairs and shoes and whatnot and stones. The ITI versus CIL match in Bangalore used to attract huge crowd. Even in Delhi, we have seen two Punjab teams, BSF and JCT meeting. There used to be good crowd at that. So there are so many instances. Why talk about Mohun Bagan East Bengal only? There are city rivalries in so many places. So what Vaibhav has said, or you are saying, or Arjun, or Siddhant is saying, it is very simple. That city rivalries take football ahead, which we know, and I am sure those who are running Indian football at the moment, they also know about it. If they don't know about it, then I'm sure they know about it. But if they are not allowing it to happen, there must be other reasons behind it. And I'm afraid...
What could be the other reason, sir? But the only reason I see is protecting your investment. An investment you made in Indian football that no one has decided to do. And you brought complete outsiders into the Indian scenario. Right? So, complete outsiders are then gauging ki, ji, yahan hum log aise kaam karte the. So, humme Indian football scenario mein aapne bola hai 20 rupaye lagane ke liye. जो एक ऐसा सिनेरियो जहां पे 2 रुपए लगते थे, ठीक है, तो हम कह रहे हैं आप हमें प्रोटेक्ट करो. तो जब तक वो 10 साल आपका खत्म नहीं होंगे मास्टर राइट्स एग्रीमेंट्स के, कुछ नहीं बदलने वाला. आपने उसी टाइम साइन मार दिया सब.
दैट मींस द रीजन इज नॉट फुटबॉल. दैट्स द ओनली वन लाइन आई कैन से. आई कांट गेट इनटू व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज द प्रॉब्लम व्हिच आई डोंट नो आई शुड से. बट एज यू सेड व्हाट यू अर्जुन इज सेइंग परहैप्स ही इज स्पॉट ऑन. आई वुड से अर्जुन इज स्पॉट ऑन. But it is again not football. That is the thing. It's a very fine kick. It has gone inside the goal at the right place, but the ball has not gone. Something else has gone. I have a feeling, isn't it?
सही बात है जनाब. दाढ़ी वाले जनाब बताइए.
जनाब क्या बताएं. It's a bit of a truism यार. मतलब सही बात है. जो ये मतलब जो हमने टॉपिक चूज किया है, आई डोंट थिंक, एंड जो कमेंट्स भी आ रहे हैं, जो लोग देख रहे हैं, सुन रहे हैं हमें, आई डोंट थिंक देयर इज एनी दो राय ऑन दिस ना. और ये लाइक जयदीप इज सेइंग, सबकी समझ में है ये बात कि सिटी राइवलरीज आर इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज इफ नथिंग एल्स आप आई मीन फॉर जियोग्राफिकल रीजंस, इफ यू हैव एनी इंटरेस्ट इन डेवलपिंग अ लीग दैट एक्चुअली ब्रिंग्स पीपल इनटू द स्टेडियम. It's another matter completely if you want to create a product that's only meant for television consumption, which I think might be the case, right? Where it doesn't really matter, like the joy that seems to be apparent these days when no spectators are visiting stadiums. Wait, tension ही नहीं है किसी के लिए.
जो दिल्ली डायनामोस पहले ही दिखा दिया कैसे किया जाता
है. ये और क्या, खाली सीटों के ऊपर फ्लेक्स लगाना हमसे बेहतर कौन जानता है.
सबसे पहले इंडियन हॉकी ने दिखाया था ये बात, ठीक है.
पायनियर्स हैं हम. एनीवेज,
अर्जुन मेरा कहना यही है.
और अब तो एक सेकंड सर, जो मैंने अब बोला ही है भाई ने,
भाई फ्लो भाई फ्लो में आ गया, भाई फ्लो में आ गया, उसके मुंह में लड्डू डाला है हमने. आप बात करने दो उसे. सिस्टम पे बात हो रही है आज.
अर्जुन मेरा एक क्वेश्चन एक ही है अर्जुन. इफ इट इज अ गुड पॉलिसी, इट्स वेरी फाइन, दो इट हैज नॉट बीन स्पेल्ड आउट, बट द बिड एडवर्टाइजमेंट कॉल्स फॉर इज clearly example that they want teams from cities where there is no ISL or I League teams, which is fine. My question is only one question: has this been put in front of the technical committee ever? Ask. You have to.
I think we've lost Jaydeep there.
We've lost Jaydeep. I think
yes,
he's back. FSDL is. Oh, yeah. Sir, FSDL ne internet to nahi le liya tha.
So, if this is the policy, if it is, has it been put in front of the technical committee? Has it been ratified by the executive committee? Please, someone stand up and ask.
But why these minutes are not out in the public? They have never put out technical committee meetings, you know.
As far as I know, and few technical committee members, I know them little bit for the last 30 years, perhaps. They have never been asked about this question.
Okay. We
have a very good friend in the technical committee.
Absolutely.
We can always politely ask him whether he has ever been asked about it. I think he might fall from the sky. I'm afraid.
My point is very simple. Sir, दूसरा नजरिया लेना भी बहुत जरूरी है. And दोस्त लोग, आप लोग जो सुन रहे हो ना, इसका मतलब ये नहीं है कि हम जो कह रहे हैं वो सही है. ये हमारा नजरिया है. And we are not moving back from our नजरिया. तो अगर if you don't agree with us, put it out there and talk about it. We're more than happy to have a healthy debate on it. See, मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ कि सर, जब आप एक इन्वेस्टर आ रहे हैं, राइट, मैं MRA पे वापस जा रहा हूँ, आप एक इन्वेस्टर आ रहे हैं, आपको कन्विंस किया गया है कि जनाब आप 20 रुपए लगाइए एक ऐसे स्पोर्ट में जिसकी फ्यूचर ये बता रहा है कि आप 5 रुपए भी नहीं बनाने वाले, ठीक है, और 20 रुपए आप 10 साल के पीरियड के लिए लगाने के लिए हम आपको कन्विंस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है, तो वो कह रहा है जनाब मेरा क्या, अब वो कह रहा है जनाब मेरा क्या, तो आप मुझे प्रोटेक्ट करो. उस नजरिए से आई कैन अंडरस्टैंड इफ यू आर ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग इन पीपल हु हैव नॉट बीन इन्वॉल्व इन द गेम, who don't know how to organically grow the game and who probably don't have the patience to organically get set in the game, right? If you have to start a new league, janab, a new league, 10 saal for a new league is not even baby steps. It is not even baby steps, keeping in mind what the Premier League and so on are doing. Mm. But yahan pe, all these things that have been done is so that in the least amount of time and the maximum amount of exposure that you can give, you try to create some awareness and some hawa that these 10 years don't go to waste. I think that is my point. Having said that, keeping in mind, because the MLS, the Major League Soccer, is okay. Where, kya kaise, hamare jo foundations hain, have all come courtesy the MLS, right?
Why the IPL? Yeah.
You could call it the IPL or MLS, whatever. I'm just saying.
No, the IPL was the first sort of, I mean, you had a proof of concept right here, right?
No,
the biggest league.
नहीं भाई, देयर इज अ डिफरेंस आईपीएल एंड थिंग. सी आईपीएल मार्जिनली आप कह सकते हैं आईपीएल. माय पॉइंट इज व्हेन यू वर टोल्ड
नो आई नीड टू कम अप विद अ कांसेप्ट, द पर्सन हु क्रिएटेड द और वेल इज क्रेडिटेड विद क्रिएटिंग द आईपीएल, वी हैव डन डिटेल्ड इंटरव्यूज विद हिम एंड ही हैज ललित मोदी एंड ही सेड वेरी क्लियरली हिमसेल्फ दैट ही सम ऑफ दीस आइडियाज ही अंडरस्टूड व्हेन ही वाज वाचिंग कॉलेजिएट स्पोर्ट व्हेन ही वाज स्टडीइंग इन द यूएस एंड ही लुक्ड एट द फ्रेंचाइज मॉडल्स एंड And so he brought that this franchise concept, right? City franchise concept to India in the form of the IPL. There was a T20 league going on in England before that, which was based on, I think, if I'm not wrong, counties, the same way that domestic cricket in England is structured even across all.
Which ideally should have worked.
Yeah. I think it does work. I mean, and now with the IPL, even that has increased in popularity as T20 cricket has grown as a format, etc., etc.
No.
So in India, we saw and we've seen sort of offspring or whatever copycat leagues emerge in all kinds of sports. From, I mean, hockey is the most glaring failure in managing to make a league work. And they've been trying for over 10 years. In different formats, different tournaments. No? Am I wrong?
भाई, वो सब आपकी बात ठीक है. मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ, the origins of this.
बोलो. जब हॉकी बोला तो भाई का हाथ खड़ा हो गया. एक सेकंड.
I don't know what you mean when you say like failure. Because
in the sense, it's not caught on in terms of, I suppose, the kind of commercial interest that Pandit was referring to.
See, I'm only trying to say when the origins of this league were around, which is, of course, a few years before the first season happened, the origins of this league, for the blueprint to be made of this league, it was given to IMG, right? Now, IMG is an American-based company. So they have picked up from what is working in America, where America, they don't have the relegation promotion system, whether it be the NBA, the MLS, or the MLB, right?
Hmm. I right? can understand so protection from have... relegation promotion
no, no. So
for some time.
My...
Yeah, I mean, yeah, but so, IMG so... also does a lot of work across Europe, Pandit. It's not fair to say that. Like,
fair enough,
I mean,
but my point is the characteristics, which ones are closer? India to America, where a sport is not supported and liked as much by a majority of the population. So how do we infiltrate that? So if it is trying, if you're trying something here, क्योंकि copy करने में तो हम champion हैं, हाँ? तो हमने कहा जी अमेरिका वाला मॉडल हमारे लिए चल सकता है, क्योंकि 25 साल से वो लगे हुए अमेरिका मॉडल जो लोगों को पता नहीं चल रहा, हालांकि वो expand करे जा रहे हैं।
It's like again,
25 साल से till now the teams are not making any money, right? 25 साल हो गए, they've been expanding to 30 teams, yes. पूरी दुनिया उनके पीछे पड़ी हुई कि आप relegation promotion शुरू करो, वो relegation promotion नहीं कर रहे। In that aspect, you have to give credit to the federation and to FSDL that घुमा फिर आके by whatever reason, in 24 they have said that they are starting relegation promotion, जो अमेरिका ने अपने 25 साल की हिस्ट्री में नहीं किया है, and it doesn't look like they plan to do it even more, even though they have more resources.
But that's they have more resources. That's exactly the point. I think for them, the expansion model, and this is, I think a catch 22 for the people that are making these decisions on top of Indian football today, because the difference between, firstly, like this works at a macro level also, from the early 90s onwards, हमारा role model America ही है, चाहे वहाँ जितना भी disaster हो, हम उसी को कॉपी करेंगे, हमारी हम फिल्में भी वैसे बनाते हैं, मतलब हमारे कपड़े भी वैसे पहनने हैं,
मैं तो नहीं देखता, म्यूजिक भी वही सुनते हैं, फॉर्मूले एक फिल्में,
तो अमेरिका इज आवर क्या कहते हैं,
इट्स अ पीक, इट्स अ माउंट एवरेस्ट,
द एल्डर ब्रदर यू ऑलवेज, द एल्डर ब्रदर यू वांट अ पीक,
या हां, सो दैट द अमेरिका बिट इज स्पॉट ऑन मेनी लेवल्स, बट with yeah again I keep losing track, I need to focus.
So while you're getting your focus back, I just want to like, sorry, but I'm like gonna go back to hockey.
I'm back. So what I was saying is America mein there's a very strong movement for the lower leagues. I think it's NASL and other such leagues.
Yeah, NSL, yeah.
USL. To institute actually relegation promotion.
Yeah.
To give at least some clubs which have, you know. But because there's so much, because of this city situation that Webber in fact referred to earlier, because of the two Los Angeles clubs, right? There is so much money in America and so much interest, because the realization has come to people now that it is not the case that soccer or football is unpopular in the US. Mm-hmm. In fact, there are very large sections of the population, just like in India, that are very deeply connected to the sport. But so a lot of money is coming in, and they have options. In Indian football, those options are much fewer, yeah? And they are likely to come from the same kind of cities where already franchises exist. So this one city situation will also come into play in that context.
See, I only think
mostly, yeah, Bombay, maybe there might be five people who want to have a club, and there should be no reason why Bombay football is not back to like Air India and.
Bhai, Bombay football mein bhai khela hai wahan pe. Bombay football, chalo chodo aap Air India aur ye Mafatlal Bafulal ko chhod do. Main to keh raha hu.
Aap
local community ki baat karo. Hum jab Bandra mein reh rahe the, to Bandra ki apni league hai wahan pe. Bandra ki league mein apne 20 teams hai, and they are playing Saturday Sunday, and it goes up for 4 months. Again. 4 months.
Wait, didn't we? One of the first episodes that we did of the 420 Grams podcast, I think way back with Stephen Dias and all these guys, where Ville Parle Premier League, you know, we were at the auction of a hyper local league. No, sorry, maybe the episode didn't see the light of day, but the Ville Parle Premier League does happen, right?
Yeah, it does happen. There was an auction.
Yeah. So where like local footballers from, I guess, Ville Parle and a slightly wider catchment area are, you know, they're going through the whole thing of like an IPL style auction, players are being have values and they are being bid for and all that. Aise ho rahe, I think hamare
why I was bringing up America, right? I'll tell you why I was bringing up America. Now see, there are a lot of characteristics that you can say yahan ho raha hai, which within 6 years of the league you can make out ki yahan bhi ho raha hai. One is that जब आपको एक्सपेंशन आपको मिलता है, राइट, कि एक फ्रेंचाइज को वहां पे एक्सपेंशन जब मिलता है कि आपके यहाँ पे फ्रेंचाइज हो गया एमएलएस का, यू आर हैंडपिक्ड बाय द एमएलएस, व्हिच इन इटसेल्फ देयर इज समथिंग रॉन्ग,
Absolutely.
Right?
I mean, now, it's happening now. Right?
They are, expansion expansion fees are going upwards of $150 million, $200 million. They're paying just for expansion fee.
And that's right? The catch 22, right? People are willing to put that money in America. But here, the fight is the opposite. Ki franchise fee aapko hatana padega.
Exactly.
No,
but which is my point. You have to give credit to the AIFF and FSDL that they've come out with a plan. But however way they might have been pushed or coerced or whatever it might be, that by 24, at least as things stand right now, you will have teams going up and down on based on merit. Based on merit. Right? वहाँ पे सर बिग ब्रदर जो हमारे हैं 25 साल से लगे हुए हैं 200 मिलियन खा रहे हैं ये खा रहे हैं वो खा रहे हैं जो भी कर रहे हैं यहाँ पे एटलीस्ट ऑन मेरिट शुरू हो गया है तो जयदीप सर इसलिए माय पॉइंट बीइंग कि आई थिंक उन्होंने ये क्या कि 24 में जब आपका खुलेगा खाता एक ऐसा सिनारियो उनको नहीं करना चाहिए कि आपने 24 में एक टीम को आपने 21 में आपने उनको एंट्री दे दी आई लीग में जिनका 24 के बाद चांस है बेंगलुरु एफसी को राइवल करने का in the same city, in the same league that they're playing in.
My point is nothing on that thing. Let them do. 24 mein kare, 34 mein kare, ya na kare, ya so far. That's a different issue altogether. My thing is that this is the third instance we are seeing, third or fourth instance we are seeing, when a team is trying to enter the I League. Is not entered on your...
Which are the other instances?
I'm talking about that U Mumbai. I'm talking about Srinidhi. Srinidhi wanted it from Hyderabad. He has been put, they have been pushed to this place.
Vizag.
Bangalore United wanted it this time to play in the I-League. They were not gate crashing into the great new league. They wanted to play in the second division only. And Indian football for the last 3-4 years, we have seen, I don't know for what reason. I don't know the reason. Let's we do some post-mortem. That second division is attracting more crowd than the first division. We don't
really?
Know. How, that's what we see. That's
of
what
course,
the I League. You're talking about the I League.
The number of teams is far
so larger.
We have seen that new teams like Aizawl, like Minerva, like Chennai City, they have created havoc. They have created a new bubble in Indian football. I League is no more about Mohun Bagan and East Bengal.
You take it
from 2014 onwards. The Indian football is about Aizawl, about Minerva, about Chennai City. They are coming up, Gokulam, coming up new clubs and doing considerably well, beating bigger clubs and winning titles. So when in your I League, when some teams are willing to come, they are not asking for promotion. They are not asking from any revolutionized system. They were never asked that whether we will be given a promotion to the new league or not. Nothing. Then why stop them? Why stop them? Are you afraid of the popularity of some of the new I League clubs?
Yeah,
am I to believe this? Well, I don't like to believe it, but some people are allowing us to believe that.
See,
that's
what I
have to say.
you're trying to protect your investment, and one of the reasons to protect your investment is the fan base, right? So we're getting 10 years to culminate and to grow a fan base that can help us then move on for the next 10 years organically. I think that is the plan. My point is, ye jo fan base jo grow hota hai, a rivalry in a city will help grow your fan base even more.
Not
the
only
buzz
that,
comes,
no,
courtesy of a rivalry.
Arjun, not only that, you can't run a team in Delhi. So you have run away to Bhubaneswar or I don't know where, Cuttack. When you can't run away run a team in Pune, then you run away to a place. And then you want to protect that place, that no other team come from that place. Is it fair? Is it a fair policy? Has it that? That's what I am asking, that such things should be ratified by the technical committee. Because technical committee is the most competent authority to decide on such things. Has they ever been asked? I'm sure they haven't.
So, off late on YouTube, I've been watching a lot of Calcutta League matches. जो साधना टीवी पे आते हैं एंड लास्ट 2-3 days ओनली आई बीन वाचिंग अ लॉट ऑफ कैलकटा लीग मैचेस एंड फॉर सम रीजन आई हैव फाउंड द एटमॉस्फेयर द क्वालिटी ऑफ द गेम बेटर देन द आई लीग एंड द ISL व्हाट हैज बीन देयर इन द कैलकटा लीग राइट माय पॉइंट इज दैट इज बिकॉज देयर इज अ सिटी राइवलरी there is a certain, you know, there's a connect, not only, of course, because there's a league that's been going on for so long.
Yeah. Everyone is much more invested.
Connect.
Can I just say?
Just imagine, like, if you have two teams in Bangalore, Bangalore FC, you have Bangalore United, you have another club that comes, and they are competing in the local league, right? A, you're giving these players a big boost to say, Kiji, local league, even if you're not playing for these three teams, we need to really go out there and punch above our weight so that these guys take a look at us, notice us, so we can get bigger contracts. So that in itself will, of course, give the league a big boost, the local league. So ground up approach tabhi banega yaar.
Arjun, I just gave
us alienate kar diya yaar.
Aapne jo Calcutta league ka baat laya, isliye main aapko ek chota sa incident batata hu. It is around 10 to 15 years back, the third division in Calcutta league, the third division league in Calcutta, two teams were vying for promotions, and both teams happened to be a particular area in Calcutta, from a particular area of 3-4 kilometers ahead.
Which area was this, sir?
I don't remember. It is somewhere in the south Calcutta. There's two areas where match could not be played that day because it was played on the open ground, because both supporters of both the clubs, they hired buses and trucks and came. And I believe they had enough number of stones in their buses and trucks, even hockey sticks, everything they came up. And it was to be played in the open ground. After watching the situation for 10 minutes, the referee said, I can't supervise this match. Please go home. Then IFA had to organize that match in a gallery ground where the spectators and the players can be separated. Referee can be put in. So for a third division promotion match could not be played by the referee. So the intensity of the rivalry of the same area comes to this. We are talking about City versus United. That's a very, very big thing. Arjun, you think about City versus Indian National. You yourself think.
Just the kind of like gentle gossip you get because of like intercity rivalry. Like I remember last year, I was there in Calcutta for the CFL when it just kicked off. And there was one game which was Mohammedan versus Aryans. Okay, and it was like I'm not going to comment on the quality of football. It was raining like mad. It was a very bad pitch. But that wasn't even the story. The scene was that Mohammedan were going to sign this striker, okay, Kuti Ademola. He had played for Minerva actually for a certain point of time. And Kuti landed at the Calcutta airport. But unfortunately, Mohammedan like ended up sending their taxi just a little late, or they couldn't send the taxi. And the Aryan guys got there and took him. So he ended up playing for Aryan against Mohammedan and scoring. It was hilarious because I was sitting in the Mohammedan stands and they were like, "Jo galia aa rahi thi, matlab ghazal likh sakte the aap un galiyon ke saath." Maza aa gaya.
Hi. Sir, bata dijiyega playlist kahan hai Spotify mein. Hum dhoond lenge aise. But batao kya, Sudeep Khare has brought out a good point and he's saying Chennai City FC again came in through a corporate entry, right?
Where do they play? Sounds like he is from my part of the country.
Which is that?
So he probably Maharashtra.
Acha.
So, anyway, wherever he is, it seems like he's not gone to see a Chennai City home game. That's why he's saying that Chennai City and Chennai in exist in the same environment.
Also, like, I can understand his confusion also because, like, Chennai City have been playing from Coimbatore, but they haven't changed their name. They haven't changed their name because they play in the CFA, like, they play League also.
Yeah.
There is no football league in Coimbatore, so they have to.
The reason, Arjun, is very simple. The reason is you want to control. You don't want to progress with the game.
It's a feudal system. Yeah. Let's not beat about the bush. कि आपने एक piece of land या कुछ टुकड़ा खरीदा है उसके साथ जो उसकी जनता है जो सब है वो आपको मतलब सूद समेत सब मिल रहा है.
That is the scene.
And what the resistance that we are seeing is bound to be there. I mean, you're right.
Shubham Nayak said, Gokulam and Kerala Blasters has a rivalry. Where does Gokulam play their games?
They don't play from Kochi again.
Kochi. No, Gokulam doesn't play.
They play from Kozhikode.
They play from Kozhikode.
Yes, they play from
Kozhikode.
That's why the big rivalry is actually Chennai City versus Gokulam, which is called the Palakkad Derby.
Yeah. Even there somehow have to, when there is so much negativity. What I am telling you, Arjun, there is so much negativity about football. When some people are ready to come, despite all this, why not welcome them with open arms and tell them, come, please.
Instead of this, you can't sit with us business all the time. Like, why not, man?
It's a big table.
It's a big country. Everyone should be able to hang out.
You are making a league where the club or the franchisee has to have 100 crores of something like in their bank account. Is it a fair system in India? That means only a handful of team can make teams. Handful of people can make teams. So that you want people with whom you feel, comfortable enough to sit across the table. I'm very blunt about it.
Big boys, that at this high table, only very few can find a seat. Fair enough, no issues. Right, you are actually putting the money where their mouths are. So why this then, Hari? Why the need for this instant return on investment?
Naval Kishore has put out a good point to what you're saying. He's saying, could it be because of TV viewership? Say for example, if one club can garner 1 million views, hypothetical. If you have two, then it's split into 400k. And 600k from a certain city.
Who knows?
Makes a fair point.
Another 50,000 might come in. Who knows?
How can you calculate that?
Like, can he tell us that another 50% to
50,000?
The point is there's one broadcaster and the game is going on one channel. ठीक है. तो चाहे वो viewership is divided 60-40, 80-20. The point is the total number of people are going to be watching that game on the same channel.
It turns out to be the same. Yeah.
The TV channel.
In fact,
it
has a chance to go even more.
I get what you're saying, boss, but.
There is a similar argument that has been made, which is that hey, if you have someone earlier had also said if you have 15,000. Fans for a Delhi club in Delhi. Then if you get two clubs, it'll be split into 7,500 each. But that's not how it works. It's not as simple as that. Like these things, I mean, if I start supporting one of the Delhi clubs,
In any case, and we are not interested in developing
particular
club's fan base, right?
Yeah.
हमें मतलब है कि overall stadium में कितने लोग आ रहे हैं match देखने.
That's all, exactly.
और अगर वो, fair enough, split है. अगर स्प्लिट है तो जो 7,500 ऑन आइदर साइड एटलीस्ट कुछ एंगेजमेंट होगा दोनों साइड्स के बीच.
जी बिल्कुल.
जैसे हम किसी भी लाइक मिजोरम प्रीमियर लीग को देख लो यार. एसेंशियली ओके मिजोरम देयर आर मेनी टीम्स फ्रॉम डिफरेंट लोकेलिटीज इन आइजोल इटसेल्फ दैट प्ले इन द एमपीएल राइट एंड यू डिफरेंट स्टैंड्स आई मीन दे आर लिटरली गोइंग एट ईच अदर इन वर्बली इट्स एन एक्सचेंज ऑफ सॉन्ग्स जोक्स chants, taunts, all of the stuff that we see in football stadiums. And Kolhapur, I mean, anywhere you go, you find where if you go and watch local league matches, you have these kind of really fun sort of rivalries. Of course, sometimes it gets out of hand and we are not at any point advocating for violence between supporters of football clubs and that kind of nonsense.
We're only advocating for poetry via abuse.
Rivalry for the third person who's not part of the rivalry. A rivalry, I would say the best way to describe it is it's infectious, right? Infectious to the point that it can pull in that third person into a rivalry between two people, right? Now, I'll give you an example of when I was working in a sports channel that we've already spoken about. And one of my jobs was to always go pick up fans from both teams that are playing and then have a conversation with them. And my brief that was always given is that make them go at each other. So instigate them to ooh and whatever, bakwas, and which is why I've left that channel after a few years, right? But the point is, jo ghar baith ke dekh raha hai, it makes for good television. It is infectious. You can pull in that person. Right? He can get pulled into your rivalry, even though he has no stake in your rivalry, right? So for all the people who are making these decisions as far as having this one city, one club, if you have a rivalry, there is nothing more organic. There is no more organic football. Even those who don't know what football is, who want to get involved in football or who don't even want to get involved in football, the best possible scenario is to create that infectious nature, right? That can then be spread and so many people can then pick up on it, right? And the mediums are there. The mediums are there to spread a rivalry. It doesn't have to depend on one PR agency. It doesn't have to depend on a TV channel. The organic mediums are there. Just some guy taking a random video of one club taking on another club, fans, phat. That in itself can spread like wildfire.
Absolutely.
You know?
Yes.
The
most important, when somebody is ready to come, the Hyderabad, one of the beat members was telling me that Srinidhi, who is coming next year, their facilities in Hyderabad is absolutely amazing.
Four playing grounds, sir, they have. It's in a school facility.
This is amazing. It's really good. But when they ask you for a place, they are not, they have no enmity with anybody. They're not trying to push out anybody. They just ask for it. And you are telling them you go to Vizag. Is it fair to them? And you have pushed a team in the city, which has actually come all over from which city we know.
Yeah.
Isn't it? If you like,
honestly, bizarre. It's honestly bizarre because, you know, see, the thing is, you would have to be crazy. And I'll say it. You would have to be crazy, keeping in mind that you want to put in a lot of money in the football in this country, right? So when you have someone who is keeping aside all of that, which is telling you don't put money into the football,
because
despite
the
fact that you should welcome them with open arms.
Yeah, because you are not in my control. You have to be in my control. Your biggest folly is you have everything, but you don't come under my control. So please, you are not welcome. That's what I don't like.
It reminds me of the same thing, like how Sidhan tribe's controlling us. Right? Aaj Arjun itna bolega, aaj Jaydeep itna bolega, Vaibhav itna bolega. Haan bhai.
Mujhe kabhi nahi bola gaya ye. Ki aap itna bologe.
Isliye aap aise karte rehte hain har baar hi bolne se pehle. Milord.
Logon ko lagega pata nahi kya zabardasti bandook laga ke iske sar pe bitha rakha hai.
अच्छा मैं ना जरा थोड़े कमेंट्स ले लेता हूँ बिकॉज काफी देर से बातचीत चल रही है श्री एन हे ब्रदर थैंक्स फॉर जॉइनिंग अस गोवा शर्ट यस दिस इज नॉट अ गोवा शर्ट दिस वाज बॉट इन कोलंबो श्रीलंका चिन्मय शेखर दत्ता हे भाई व्हाई सो लेट यार भाई दिस वाज टेक्निकल इश्यूज ना भाई कोलंबो
व्हाई इज नोबडी लाइक लाइकिंग माय शर्ट लाइक मैंने भी अच्छा शर्ट पहना है
बना आप हिपस्टर हैं आप पे कमेंट करना हमें शोभा नहीं देता है
आप कमला नगर में कोई पहाड़ी कैफे में चाय पीए नवल किशोर थैंक्स फॉर जॉइनिंग बड़ी पवनीत पेनी हो ही इज अ रेगुलर वॉचर ऑफ द शो व्हाट्स अप भाई ही सेइंग नोटिफिकेशन ही नहीं आई for the producer who's
thank you
right
thank
now.
You for bringing that up guys
thanks yeah. thanks Pavneet and guys if you have any feedback please do put it out there because we listen we hear all your comments Hirendra Digar se saying Pandit ji aapko nahi ghadi le leni chahiye bhai iske bare mein baat hogi hai Ankit Singh right on time thank you Shubham Nayak ke bare mein humne baat kar liye Jijo who's a friend of Siddhant's Jijo thanks for joining us Akshat Patel has joined us Pulkit Malhotra Or Mohanot is saying where Indian football team will start playing friendly matches. I don't think that is happening in this year at least. Then while we were of course putting that screen share, Shri and said, bro, podcast is better than screen sharing. Pandit ji, aapko nahi ghadi le leni chahiye. Theek hai. Presley FR is saying one city, one rule is not good. Aryanshi Mohan, who is of course handling our backend. She's of course watching the entire chat. Shubham Nayak hai, Mehboob Alam, thanks for joining us. Hansi Kursh is saying too much lag happening. Get Richard on a proper program. Okay, sir. Akib Khan is saying ghadi, ISF, badi der laga di. Akshat Patel, rubbish rule. He's calling this one city, one rule. Safin Bunny is saying nice shirt. Thanks, Safin. Then you have Shubham.
He's going to read Jaka all of Kharkongar. The nice shirt comments. Huh?
Yeah. He's just doing this. Of course. This is rubbing it in. Huh?
Of course.
Sorry,
of course.
This is not right.
Bhai, dekhiye. Hum hai FSDL. Hum chala rahe hain yahan pe hamara sikka.
One shirt, one rule. One shirt, one rule on one show.
Then Abhishek Mehrotra is saying, discuss the quality and prospect of the India under 16. Buddy, I think we'll do it closer to their AFC championship, which is, I think, sometime in November. So all those of you who are asking us to talk about under 16.
That's getting a lot of problems, I believe, because they have not started the camp yet.
Yes.
And the matches are in November and we have a graveyard of a group.
The other countries are sort of doing a little bit better. So they are...
Group of death, actually.
I don't think the tournament will... Do you think it's likely to go ahead? If the AFC has postponed World Cup qualifiers, then
they have postponed a lot of things, but not these matches.
But they probably will.
I think it's a problem because it's a date of birth problem.
There are lots of issues. People lose out, the kids lose out because these things are quite fine-tuned.
We promise to do a full chat on this soon, but not right now. Aaj August chal rahi hai, yaar. September mein karenge agar karenge, taki then we'll have clarity on whether the tournament is happening, not happening.
Yes.
If the Indian camp is happening, not happening. So it makes sense to talk then. Hirendra Digarse saying the One City One franchise setting really helped FC Goa. Anyone wants to get in on that? Because it has helped FC Goa, because you know,
I think there's a comment
there
like I think there's a comment soon
city
after
or state, it is FC Goa, huh?
So there's a comment soon after where someone is saying it did not help Goan clubs. So I would suggest both of you meet each other and like thrash this out in true football fans.
But point being, it helped FC Goa. That's the point. Whether it helped Goan clubs or not, theek hai, but it has helped FC Goa.
But it has not helped too many Goan players. When there was 5-6 clubs were playing, there were too many Goa local players were there.
You could play more.
Yeah, that is one thing is not happening. And Goa, Arjun, you have played in Goa. You know how vibrant is the Goa.
I mean, and Goa is not even a city. I mean, it's
How vibrant. There was a time when 4 teams or 5 teams from Goa were playing in the National League. The Goa football was so vibrant. That has gone. And people who have been investing on Goa football for the last 50 years, more than that. Salonka Club was born in 1955. It is now how much? 65 years. That has completely gone out. Dempo has gone out. França has gone out.
Dempo is coming back to youth football.
You cannot blame this the only reason they have gone out. But enthusiasm has gone down.
Yes.
Enthusiasm has certainly gone down.
Watermelon shirt, love it.
You know, we got to also just do a quick promo, free promo here, guys, because eventually we will require 420 grams will also require all this fantastic support that we have from people who watch us. We will also have to translate into some cash money at some point. And one way, Patreon and all this stuff we'll start doing, but. But you know, ये हम बोया को free में दे रहे हैं क्या कहते हैं?
सर आपने किस चूहे को मारा यहाँ पे?
Screen space दे रहे हैं. तो बोया microphones actually आजकल ये सब बोलना नहीं चाहिए because I think this stuff is all made in China.
आप anti-national हैं.
तो अभी हाँ वही है ना यहाँ भी anti-national करार देंगे. So, but at the risk of doing that, I'm saying there is some space for visual promotions on this fantastic platform. So. Brands, if you're watching and interested, please do get in touch with us.
And this fuzzy microphone looks much better when you have a beard.
Kind of blends in with the whole scene.
I can confirm to you that only one brand is watching.
Yeah.
And that brand was Sadak Chhaap Kachha Banyan. Bas ye log. Jo ek wo Sadak Chhaap Kachha Banyan also is gone. Keh raha hai yaar ye kaisa show hai.
Yeah.
ठीक है मैं आई एम जस्ट सॉरी जस्ट मुश्ताक अहमद सिंह बेटिंग फॉर संडे ओनली रीजन 420 ग्राम्स थैंक्स मुश्ताक लव यू फॉर कनेक्टिंग एंड ट्यूनिंग इन Mushtaq is of course then trying to spam us. Chinmoy Shekhar Datta is saying, Arjun, still not sure for 2024 merit rule. FSDL may make something else getting close to 2024. It's a possibility though. You never know. Just going by the track record of the way rules are changed, not changed, new rules come in. You never know. Sudeep Khare ki humne baat kar li. Our time is saying, hello guys, how's the day? The day is beautiful in Delhi, bhai. Hamare bhai Pune mein baithe hain. Sir, kaisa hai din Pune mein?
बहुत बढ़िया यहाँ तो मौसम बहुत बढ़िया है कभी कभी पंखा चलाना भूल जाते हैं
The best thing is Siddhant looked out as if he has a window on his left he doesn't
I do
Shri NS said a very nice thing he's saying
can only see into my neighbor's apartment from the window but there's a window
Shri NS said a very nice thing he's saying Siddhant 55 गरीब लोग देख रहे हैं sorry no brands
सर आप
गरीब नहीं हो you are rich in knowledge दिल के आप अमीर हैं इसका मतलब आप गरीब ही हैं और कुछ नहीं है हाँ ठीक है anything else you guys want to add as far as this
there was a question for Jaideep I saw
did I miss it
I think so yeah something asking about Siliguri North Bengal
yes even I saw that yes
I think any of you guys can take it because we've all been to Siliguri and watched football there so any of us can take it question is essentially what sort of If a club from Siliguri were to emerge, how would that change the dynamics of football? Because North Bengal is currently under or not represented at the.
I can tell you, it'll seriously weaken Mohammedan Sporting's team. They have 3 players from Siliguri, and if the boys decide to stay home.
Siliguri has a good football league. Siliguri do have a good football league, but it has not expanded.
I have a question for Jaideep. Don't you think northern part of Bengal is totally ignored?
Yes.
If a team came from Siliguri, how will their support base be? Is the support base Siliguri mein kaafi?
Bahut acha hai. I have done lots of tournaments in Siliguri. I have done Federation Cup in Siliguri. I have covered even Nehru Cup many years ago in Siliguri. The thing is that it is a problem which should be handled by their local authorities. That means IFA. They should generally, in the second division, clubs are taken from the Calcutta League only, and Siliguri clubs don't play in the. They play in their own league. Only. And well, Siliguri is finally represented in the inter-district only, and in the inter-district, some of the local players, if they are good, they are coming to Calcutta play in the local league. It has often happened like that, but I think it's a very interesting thing. The entire northern party, they have a good football. Way out should be made out so that they can be also representative. Northern part of Bengal is like perhaps the more than the state of Punjab. It is so big.
Yeah.
So I think if I'm not mistaken, last year the Durand Cup they wanted to hold one group's matches in Siliguri, and there was a huge amount of excitement. But then finally it was like shifted out and.
See, Siliguri. Siliguri has hosted many matches. Siliguri has hosted I-League matches. Siliguri Federation Cup, Nehru Cup. Yeah. Siliguri has hosted
national team.
Everything.
This when the game that Chetri. Became India's highest international goal scorer was at I think Kanchenjunga Stadium.
Kanchenjunga Stadium. Siliguri.
I think it was at Siliguri. I think I was there. For
But that is not enough because then you have to give a representation to Siliguri also.
Absolutely.
Siliguri has a league. Siliguri has a full-fledged league. Well, let's not get into what is the standard of the league. That way, the standard of the league of several other leagues can be questioned. I can start from the top. मुश्किल यह है सिलीगुड़ी क्लब्स डू नॉट हैव एनफ मनी टू रिक्रूट 5 फॉरेनर्स इफ यू अलाउ देम टू रिक्रूट 5 फॉरेनर्स दे विल ऑल्सो बी वेरी गुड क्लब्स नॉट ए प्रॉब्लम बट समहाउ IFA हैज नॉट गिवन देम प्रॉपर रिप्रेजेंटेशन Not only Siliguri, for that matter, there are so many good clubs in Bengal districts. They have not received proper representations.
This is the flip side of it, by the way.
NDR Shadow Gamer, I'm not ignoring you, brother. Love you.
It's an important thing that actually this has led to, which is that there are also things can also work ulta. In that, if I look at it from the perspective of the AIFF, let's say I'm the AIFF and I'm trying to promote the game or increase the footprint of the game, then one logic I can understand for having this is that you go away from these so-called traditional centers, right? Where you don't only have clubs based in Bombay, Bangalore, et cetera, Calcutta, of course, and so on. And it might work for a club as well. In a place like Coimbatore, in a place like Vizag, in a place like Siliguri, having a club in these places will lead to people coming to the grounds. It will lead to local players getting a sort of boost in terms of how their careers can progress and seeing that happen literally in front of them. It can also, what happens in many cases we've seen is where these cities like London clubs dominate English football in a sense. I mean, maybe, okay, Manchester, there's also Manchester and Liverpool, I get that. But just if you look at overall numbers, I'm not talking about who wins the league. Yeah. Look at the number of clubs that there are.
London has won Champions League.
I'm not talking about who wins. Forget about the results, who wins the league. And
you're just talking numerically.
We're just talking numerically, yeah.
Correct.
That big cities, like Calcutta, you're saying, the IFA is not supposed to represent only Calcutta football. It's supposed to represent all of Bengal, right? But what happens when you have so many big clubs in Calcutta itself is that it's very easy to forget what's happening in the districts, what's happening outside. So your entire focus becomes on Calcutta mein kya ho raha hai, because jo aapke powerful voting members hain, influential wale hain, jo 100 saalon se jinka chal raha hai, wo sab wahin pe locally based hai. So that is a flip side that is part of the logic of what they're trying to do.
Siddhant, the biggest folly is that a vast land of India, UP, Bihar and Madhya Pradesh have become completely untapped.
In fact, we should get someone like Nishu on the show when we can to talk about UP and what the point being,
Nishu want to come on our show?
Yeah, why not, man?
When we tried getting in touch with players and asking them to come and join us. But if any of you have, of course, Nishu's, if you want Nishu to join us on the show, then do let us know in the comments section. So, aapne UP, Bihar and MP ki baat kari. I think for that, a large part of the blame lies with, of course, the state associations.
Of course.
Large part of the blame lies with the state association and no one else.
And full of vested interest.
Full of vested interest. That is the thing. Yeah. Hands down. But I agree with you. So I'll tell you what we're
Adeep
rounding
sir,
up the conversation.
First of all, everyone is ignoring my shirt. You have also ignored my state. It's amazing, sir. Chalo, koi baat nahi.
No, but your state's biggest star is the secretary. your state at least have some 4 or 5 women players who are playing for India.
Correct.
What about the states like UP? It's such a vast state. What about MP? What about Rajasthan? After Magan Singh, not a single player has come, and Magan Singh last played for India, I think, in 1978. It's now 42 years. Not a single player from Rajasthan has played for India. Just imagine. How sad it is, isn't it?
It is. It's quite terrifying.
I'm going to round up the conversation now, guys, because again, we've crossed the 60-minute barrier. I won't call it a barrier. I think 60-minute mark, because it's normal for us. Who wants to take it up? Closing comments for everyone. And then I'll say goodbye to everyone on the show. Who wants to start on this? If you have words of advice for the Federation, if you have words of advice for the fans, if you'd like to make a revelation, whatever it is, please go ahead.
No, I guess a little bit of self-promotion is in order as usual. sorry, Jerry, to jump in before you.
प्रमोशन का नाम लिया ना भाई ने भगवान ने भाई का भाई इंटरनेट काट दिया और करो प्रमोशन सर आप बताओ आप पहले बोल रहे थे
मैं बोल रहा था फुटबॉल इज अ डेमोक्रेटिक प्रोसेस दिस शुड नॉट बी इन द हैंड्स ऑफ अ फ्यू पीपल हु आर कंट्रोल फ्रीक इंडियन फुटबॉल विल ओनली एक्सपेंड व्हेन इट विल बी डेवलप्ड डेमोक्रेटिकली not in the artificial manner. That's what I mean.
Fair enough. Janab, internet ne aapki promotion kaat di thi wahan pe.
Bilkul.
But
I'll take it as a sign and let it be till next time. But just wanted to say to people who are watching that, you know, it's a team effort also. So when you say ye promote karo, wo promote karo, ideas humare paas bhi bhatere hain bhai. To agar aap log ko jo hum karte hain, usse kuch milta hai, kuch theek lagta hai, like we are... taking the questions that you are giving us and having this discussion around Indian football. And if you think that that is of some value, then please also within your circles, your communities, your friends who enjoy the sport, help us out by promoting it as well. It's not something that we can manage on our own. So, jaise hamara Instagram hai, bahut sahi baat hai. NewsClick Sports hai. Aap log Instagram pe agar hain, to please wahan pe like karein, jo bhi karein, follow karein.
NewsClick Sports on Instagram. Give it a follow.
That's basically it. Keep coming back. We've gone from 100 people last week to, I think, half that number this week. Maybe your Sundays are getting busier. I don't know. Maybe we're not promoting it well enough.
I'm going to say it's simply because we're not as good looking as Renedy and Ishfaq.
Fair enough. So,
bro,
so
speak for yourself, bro.
Speak
for yourself.
100%. I'm not going to say
guys, we will do all this super chat and all of that. We will start doing some of that.
And
we want to build up a little bit first.
When are you starting the channel?
We'll have that big reveal. You know, I'm getting younger by the year, so because and everything, it's all like aap log ne bol diya, it's all about me. So, mera kya kehte hain, meri salgirah aane wali hai, to uske aas pass thoda launch party karenge. Zoom call pe aap sabke saath.
Kya baat hai. Haan ji janab,
but tab tak ke liye aise koi dikkat nahi hai. Kabhi kabhi notification nahi aa raha, agar koi baat nahi, hum keh rahe hain ki 2 baje या 2 baje के आसपास every Sunday we will be on NewsClick's YouTube channel. I think we have close to 2.5 million subscribers on the channel. So I'm not sure where the 2.4 something million are
Modi
this
ji?
Sunday. but you can in the meantime you can catch us here as well.
Okay, great. Santosh Reddy, मेरे भाई, मैं दुबई नहीं जा रहा हूँ. मैं अगर जाऊँगा तो शायद मुंबई जाऊँगा. लेकिन यहाँ पे क्रिकेट की बात नहीं हो रही, हम फुटबॉल की बात कर रहे हैं. मेरे भाई, वन गाय सिंह, संजीव बसवास सिंह, आई थिंक 2 PM इज टू अर्ली, यू कैन स्टार्ट अराउंड 3 PM. सो भाई, हमारी कैटेगरी का भाई है फिर. तो लेट उठता है क्योंकि सैटरडे नाइट इसका हैवी होता है.
सर, देख लो यार, मतलब अगर जयदीप सर कैन बी तैनात अपनी पोजीशन पे एट 1:45, आई थिंक सो कैन यू माय फ्रेंड मिस्टर बिस्वास.
मिस्टर बिस्वास, गेट योर एक्ट टुगेदर.
क्या एक दिन भाई,
लाइक
नहीं तो 3 बजे तक हम लगे ही रहते हैं. 3 क्या 4 बजने वाले हैं, तो यू आप टहलते टहलते आ जाइएगा जब आप उठे 3 बजे.
वेब ऑफ फाइनल थॉट्स ऑन द चैट दैट वी हैड.
वेल, आई थिंक इट्स फेयर टू से दैट आई हैव द बेटर टी-शर्ट or as a shirt. That's my final comment. I don't care what the fans think.
हमने 1.5 घंटे यहाँ पे one city one rule की बात करी है. यहाँ पे you're fighting one t-shirt one person. हद होगी यार. Beyond that, bro.
No, the serious thing is like there is like when you look at the comments, there's everyone is like there are people disagreeing. There has been some people who are bringing up problems if you bring in more teams from one city. But the crucial element of thing is like these disagreements, these like matbhed. इसी से तो बनता है फुटबॉल. और अगर आप मतभेद बंद कर दें और एक सुप्रीम अथॉरिटी के द्वारा सब कुछ दिया जाए तो फुटबॉल वो डजंट वर्क लाइक दैट.
बिल्कुल,
जाते जाते लोगों ने याद दिलाया कि आज चैंपियंस लीग फाइनल है.
हाँ, तो, ना, मैं भी वैसे पे आने वाला था. कमेंट देख रहे हो जना,
बड़ी स्क्रीन पे लगा.
तो फिर सर, अच्छा ठीक है, तो सर जाते जाते सब बता दो जी अपना 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 यहाँ पे क्या कहते हैं, गिव अस योर टेक ऑन हु विल विन द चैंपियंस लीग. वी डोंट वांट अ डिस्कशन, एन एक्सप्लेनेशन, बिकॉज वी विल होल्ड यू टू इट. once we do our next show. Jaideep sir, PSG or Bayern Munich?
PSG. My PSG. Money is on PSG.
Okay, Vaibhav.
I want them to win, that's all.
I don't want PSG to win, but they will win 3-1.
Okay. For Nyota aaya tha
kaise
batane hai
but
I have come from the future, mujhe pata hai.
Haan ji sahab,
hey PSG yaar.
PSG Kylian Mbappe who can break that high line. Sir, high line पे Manuel Neuer भी आगे आता है आपके high line पे.
I remember him against South Korea. It was amazing.
I remember him versus India at Nehru Stadium. He was amazing then also.
Yeah.
Because I remember him after the match when he was walking down the tunnel. What a guy, man. That Manuel Neuer. I said, hey, Manuel, English interview. He said, I don't know English. And he walked away. Yeah, what a guy, bro.
That's amazing.
Na le li usne.
Amazing.
Theek hai. By the way, Vaibhav, one guy said, Vaibhav bhai, we love you. Lovely t-shirt.
But so, if there are any Bayern fans like Pandit, you can catch. Once upon a time, we had a Bayern legend on the show.
Zarazu.
Yeah.
But we must also point out that he is French.
Aryanshi, if you're still here, if you're watching, can you just post a link to that in the comments, maybe, so that people can check out that interview if they want to.
Okay. The chat is now bordering on random because which
yes,
is random.
We should, I think.
Next thing you know, we start doing. I'll end this now. I'll say this, that look, one city, one team, while on the one hand, you're trying to protect the interests of people who have done nothing that's been done before in Indian football. So my point is nothing in the sense who have the magnitude of investment and commitment that hasn't been shown in Indian football. You're trying to protect those people from doing that, right? But on the other hand, because you're trying to protect them, you're not letting it grow in their own cities. Organically jo grow hota hai na, uska koi value hai hi nahi. It is, you cannot put a value on it. Uska mol hi nahi hai. Because jo organically grow hota hai na, wo lamba grow hota hai and it's sustainable. Wo apne aap sustainable banta hai. To wo aap karne hi nahi de rahe ho. Hopefully, I think, see, aapne promotion relegation at least shuru kar di hai. Chahe jo bhi hua, jo bhi aapka aapne yahan pe beech mein gand hua hai, chale ja raha hai kaafi time se. Ek cheez aapne achhi kari hai. कि आपने प्रमोशन रेलिगेशन शुरू कर दिए एंड दैट इन इटसेल्फ
इन थ्योरी मेरिट
लेट अ बैंगलोर यूनाइटेड हां
इन थ्योरी ओनली वी आर येट टू सी ऑल दिस हैपन
सर बट
एज ऑफ नाउ देयर इज नो प्रमोशन रेलिगेशन
नहीं ऑन पेपर ठीक तो है ना
सो फार इफ द रूल डजंट चेंज अगेन
इफ द रूल डजंट चेंज ऑन पेपर
मूड पे डिपेंड
ऑन पेपर आपने मान लिया है कि आपका एक सिस्टम बनने वाला है जहां आपका सेकंड डिवीजन थर्ड डिवीजन बनेगा जहां आपका आई लीग सेकंड डिवीजन बनेगा जहां आपका आईएसएल मेन डिवीजन बनेगा हम तो वही कह रहे हैं जनाब फिर उस सिस्टम को आप 10 साल बाद देखना और फिर मुझे बताना राइवलरी बन रही है नहीं बन रही है कि आपके ऑर्गेनिक प्लान्स आ रहे हैं नहीं आ रहे हैं सस्टेनेबल ग्रोथ हो रहा है नहीं हो रहा है ये सब होगा जब आपका ये सिस्टम आ जाएगा इन प्लेस होपफुली इफ नो वन टिंकर्स विद दैट सिस्टम मोर राइट दैट इज द मेन थिंग स्टॉप टिंकरिंग अराउंड नाउ विद दिस थिंग स्टॉप टिंकरिंग अराउंड
I guess if I bring another point up, maybe we'll have to go for another half an hour. So we also maybe should be thinking about a combination of an expansion model along with promotion relegation. So where you consistently also, and this applies to all of the leagues, not just the ISL, but you consistently also over time keep expanding the lower leagues as well. So because we are only at a stage where we have, like we are still in the 10, 12, team bracket range. It needs to, India is a massive country with, I think, and as time progresses, the top league should be 20 teams and then lower on, it should increase proportionately, you know. So both things should be considered maybe, not just any one approach to it. And also, I mean, like this is one of the really, it's a we've gone on for 2 hours and we should really wind up. But it's an extremely pertinent thing because across the country, we are seeing an attack on democracy and democratic values, you know, irrespective of what area you look at. Whether it's, we talk about the branches of government and today, the ways in which the judiciary is trying to assert itself, you know, across the field, I mean, whether it's the executive branch, to hum dekhi rahe hain kya ho raha hai. So, and football does reflect that extremely, extremely accurately and in a very timely manner. It doesn't take, you know, what is happening outside very quickly translates into what's happening in football. And we've seen over the past 8, 6, 8, 10 years, a consistent erosion of democratic values on which the structure before that or even today is supposed to be based. These are sports code vagaira ki baat karte hain. All of these things are only applicable to the federation, you know. The private entities ko agar hum de denge sab, to there will be no ki aisa hona chahiye, nahi hona chahiye. Fir to, it will only be driven by commercial factors. And our essential thing is that is too much.
भाई देखो जी हमारे जो बंदे हैं, देखो हम परिवार बन गए. ये है परिवार की सबसे जबरदस्त बात. जब हमारा भाई सिस्टम पे आ गया वापस, तो एक इंडियन फुटबॉल हमने क्या भाई, फिर से गवर्नमेंट. भाई देखो, ये हमारी निशानी है. हम छूटते नहीं है. जो दिल में बात होती है उसको आपके सामने रख देते हैं, बाकी आपके ऊपर है. आपको सही लगे गलत लगे वो
बिल्कुल गाली दें आप, कोई दिक्कत नहीं है.
बिल्कुल मैं खत्म करने वाला हूँ. मैं जस्ट अब खत्म करूंगा प्रमोशन से. प्रमोशन ये है मेरे प्यारे लोगों, देखो हर संडे दो बजे न्यूज क्लिक इनके फेस नहीं
यूट्यूब
संडे 2 बजे न्यूज क्लिक के यूट्यूब पेज पे हम लोग आएंगे, बैठक करेंगे. रेनेडी सिंह है, इश्वाक अहमद है, जयदीप बासु है, वैभव रघुनंदन है, सिद्धांत एनी है और मैं हूँ. काफी लोग हैं और कभी कुछ पर्टिनेंट यहाँ पे स्पेसिफिक टॉपिक्स की बात करनी होगी तो उन लोगों को भी हम लोग यहाँ पे लाएंगे. तो आपको नोटिफिकेशन अगर आपको यूट्यूब का नहीं मिलता, कोई बात नहीं. इंस्टाग्राम पे तो आप सब लोग हो गए, फोटो तो अपनी लेते ही हो, टिकटॉक वीडियो बनाते ही हो. टिकटॉक तो अब हट गया लेकिन स्टोरी बनाते ही हो. इंस्टाग्राम पे जाओ, न्यूज क्लिक स्पोर्ट्स, जस्ट टाइप न्यूज क्लिक स्पोर्ट्स एंड स्टार्ट गिविंग देम अ फॉलो. बड़े देर से इनकी गाड़ी 202 पे अटकी हुई है भाई लोगों. इनकी गाड़ी बढ़ाओ 300 तक, ठीक है, 300 तक गाड़ी बुलाओ. और ये जो हमारे एपिसोड है, आपके जो सारे दोस्त लोग हैं, ऐसा आई फेल टू बिलीव दैट इट इज ओनली यू हु वॉचेस फुटबॉल इन योर सर्कल और इट इज ओनली यू हु इज बॉदर अबाउट फुटबॉल इन योर सर्कल. स्टार्ट स्प्रेडिंग आवर एपिसोड्स एज मच एज पॉसिबल. हमारी जो यहाँ पे बतिया रहे हैं, इतनी क्लोज फैमिली है, इसको थोड़ा और बड़ा करो. नॉट फॉर एनी सेल्फिश रीजंस, हमें ज्यादा पैसे नहीं मिलने वाले. हम तो बस ये कह रहे हैं कि हमारी जो बातें हैं और इतना हमने एक्सपीरियंस गैदर किया है, वो ज्यादा लोगों तक पहुंचेगा तो अच्छा रहेगा. ठीक है, आज के लिए इतना ही. जयदीप सर, सिद्धांत एंड वैभव, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. सिद्धांत इज गिविंग मी दैट लुक कि ये पंडित चुप ही नहीं हो रहा.
थैंक यू.
मैं कौन होता हूं भाई चुप करने
वाला. ठीक है, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग एंड स्प्रेड दिस एपिसोड एज मच एज पॉसिबल एंड स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग अस ऑन इंस्टाग्राम. न्यूज क्लिक स्पोर्ट्स इज द हैंडल. संडे 2 PM विदाउट फेल वी विल बी हियर डिस्कसिंग अनदर ब्रांड न्यू एपिसोड ऑफ 420 ग्राम्स. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग.
थैंक यू गाइस. थैंक्स.